Hi there, this is a follow-on to an earlier video on the XLOOKUP function across worksheets. At business unit companies have various financial data, which we can take to calculate the IRR using the XIRR formula in Excel. Like this previous video, we want to calculate the respective IRR for each entity on the summary sheet. Firstly, let's compute each worksheet's IRR using the XIRR formula because our time series isn't uniform. Given our sheet layouts and cell ranges are the same, we can use the group feature to simultaneously derive all IRRs like so. This quick exercise will help validate the IRR numbers presented on the summary sheet are working in this exercise. We can start composing the IRR for Alpha on the summary sheet. Like the XLOOKUP video, we must correctly apply the indirect function for each syntax element of the formula as we need to reference the respective range in the source Alpha worksheet. It is vital to correctly type these formulas accurately, otherwise the dynamic XIRR formula won't work. This first part of the formula references row 8 containing the EBITDA numbers across the time series. The second part needs to refer to the time series of the source data set in order to calculate the internal rate of return. Please take your time writing these formulas because it is very easy to mistype the syntax in these indirect formulas. As you can see, row 3 in the alpha sheet contains the time series, which this second indirect function must reference. Our formula is complete. Let's fill down the dynamic XIRR formula. In summary, I will apply the formula text to capture the syntax of the XIRR indirect formulas for your reference. Let's check our formulas against the individual worksheet formulas of XIRR. Our internal rate of return formulas are working correctly.